Hi there, it's Ms. Coventry, ready to talk with you about another one of our library databases. This time I'm finding it on a LibGuide for another 10th grade project called Past Meets Present. When I scroll down, I can see a listing of history databases here. And we do have videos available on ProQuest historical newspapers already, and also on Britannica School. And today I want to talk about History Study Center, this one over here. This database comes to us from ProQuest and also from Chadwick Healy, I believe, and it's actually a British site. In order to get the username and password, you're going to take a look at the document that we have, a Google Doc called Library Resources Passwords. You can find that on the same research guide or in various links on various LibGuides. When you type in the password, you are brought to this main page. And what I like about this particular resource is actually the section that's on study units. If, for example, I was looking for information on Indian independence, I would see that there are actually 29 study unit results, in addition to a listing of historical documents, maps, multimedia, as well as journals. And notice they have 1,000 results that are found in terms of the journals. So although 5 show up, if I click the more results, I'll get more of those particular journals. But I like to start inside of these study units because usually those study units include almost all of the pieces that I'm going to need. So I'm going to take a look at India and independence and partition, 1920 to 1947. There is a great sort of introductory piece right at the beginning. And then I see that there's a list and quick links to take me right to primary sources or videos or web links or related study units. I'm going to jump down to primary sources, and I can see a whole collection of primary sources listed, including what dates they're at. So if I want something that's before 1942 or before 1940, I would stay up in this area here where I can actually see the entire speech that Mahatma Gandhi gave. And then I can read that speech in its entirety. The part that's in italics is actually sort of a commentary. The part that isn't in italics is the actual speech. If I decided that I wanted to use this, I could click the Cite This button where I'm given the information. Here is the information. What I also recommend you do is actually look at where it says Show Edit Citation. So I can actually copy and paste these particular pieces right into my citation system, right into Noodle Tools. So I can use each of these pieces because the citation style here is Modern Language Association. If I was doing a history project, I would maybe need Chicago. So I would need that to be slightly different. What I also want to include, this just gives me the site of History Study Center. And what I would want to include, I need to go back, would be the actual URL to get back to this particular resource. And that's going to be this button right here that says durable URL. This durable URL is what would get me right back so that I could get into that document in the future. And I can have that in Noodle Tools so I can open that up again. The other great thing about this is that I know this is a book because it says Book of Historic Speeches, who the publisher is, when it was published. I get that information here as well as more specifics when I click that Cite This button. If you have questions about this resource or any other library resource, feel free to contact us in the library via chat, text, email, whatever works for you. Thanks and have a great day.